2 years ago, Adrian Peterson lit up the college football world, rushing for nearly 2,000 yards. He was second in the Heisman vote, the highest ever for a freshman. Despite battling ankle injuries last year, he still broke the 1,000-yard barrier. And in two games this season, the junior sensation is averaging over 150 yards a game. Peterson's the best running back in college football. Now he comes to Eugene to continue his high-stepping ways to the Heisman Trophy. But today, the Ducks of Oregon have other plans for these Oklahoma Sooners. The Sooners and the Ducks are on a collision course straight ahead. Good afternoon, everybody. Dan Fouts. The Oregon Ducks are 2-0 on the season, having beaten Stanford and Fresno State. But this is a game they've waited 9 years for. A chance to avenge last year's Holiday Bowl loss to the Sooners. And a chance to see just how well their sophomore sensation, Jonathan Stewart, matches up against the great Adrian Peterson. My partner is Tim Brandt. Tim, welcome as well. The Oregon Ducks desperately need to have a healthy and productive Jonathan Stewart today.
Well, so much of Oregon's game plan involves Jonathan Stewart, and he's been limited for 14 days now. Let's go back to that very first game. He ran for 168 yards against Stanford, but on this play right here, he landed awkwardly, got rolled up on, sprained his ankle. He's only carried the ball one time since. We just talked to Stewart earlier, and he said he's still not 100%, but he wants the ball 20 to 25 times today. If he's not in there, Jeremiah Johnson comes in. He's been stellar. Different kind of runner, good change-up guy. He's a dash and dart guy. He's averaging over 6 yards a carry. And Dennis Dixon, the quarterback, the trigger man, has not been sacked, has not thrown an interception. Today, he's got to be clean. He's got to get on the edge, and Oregon will have a good, solid chance here at home.
Well, for Oklahoma, they're also 2-0 on the season, and quarterback Paul Thompson has been very solid. But we're in for a real treat today, folks, to get to see Adrian Peterson run.
I think you agree. Adrian Peterson's the best running back in college football. He's big, he's strong, he's fast, he's got incredible instincts. They call him AD all day because he gets stronger as the game goes on. As a matter of fact, more than 60% of his career yards come in the second half. And when defenses load the box, then Paul Thompson, like last week, Washington loaded the box, Paul Thompson does play action, went 9 for 11 and a touchdown. Paul Thompson, if he doesn't hurt him today with turnovers, Oklahoma will be right in the thick of this thing late.
Well, the Sooners have never lost to the Ducks in 6 games, but this is Oklahoma's first visit to Autzen. Capacity's 54,000, but close to another 5,000 standing room only crazies hope to make this a day the Sooners will never forget. The kickoff is next. Well, Oklahoma has won the toss, but they will defer. Oregon will receive. Bob Stoops is in his 8th season leading the Sooners. What a job he's done. 77 wins, the national title, and return to prominence for Oklahoma football. And Mike Bellotti last week became the winningest coach in school history. Back in 2001, he led the Ducks to a number 2 ranking and a Fiesta Bowl win.
I think the most important stat there, you told me, he's only lost one non-conference opponent here at home during his tenure.
24-1 non-conference foes here in Autzen Stadium for Mike Bellotti. This is Garrett Hartley, back deep for Oregon. This will be Jonathan Stewart. Across the 20 to the 25-yard line, Jacob Gutierrez on the tackle for Oklahoma. Quarterbacking the Ducks will be junior Dennis Dixon. He's been cool and confident, and he is a dual threat. He's rushed for a touchdown and thrown for a touchdown in the first 2 games of the season. Stewart will open in the backfield for Oregon, number 28. The left side of Dixon. Ball marked at the 24-yard line for this first play. It's the option. No, Dixon's going to throw now. Almost intercepted. Zach Latimer had his hands on that. Today, Tim, this offensive line of Oregon is going to be tested. They were embarrassed last year in that Holiday Bowl by the quickness of the front four of Oklahoma.
Yeah, the offensive line averages well over 300 pounds. You know, football's a game of angles and options and getting space. It's up to them to get Stewart space.
Second and 10. Four wide receivers fake to Stewart. Now the quick pass outside to Jason Williams. 40, 20. Pushed out of bounds by Reggie Smith inside the 10-yard line.
Well, Dixon almost threw a pick on his first pass play. But then they come back and fake a little play action to Stewart, and they get the little slip screen out there to the wide receiver. Now just watch this. One step up, go back, get a blocker, catch the football, now turn it loose. He's got one guy to beat. Gets a block on him, and that's just enough to nudge him and get him into the open. It's a foot race. Huge game by Oregon. And that, folks, is a mindful, big confidence builder for Oregon.
Broke a tackle of Jason Carter, 67 yards on that completion. Bottom of the screen is Garen Strong taking Williams' spot here. First and goal for the Ducks. The hand inside to Stewart, breaks a tackle inside the five, down to the 2-yard line. Another broken tackle, this time Zach Latimer can't bring him down. Defensive lineups for the Sooners. When you talk defense in Oklahoma, you talk about the great Rufus Alexander.
Well, he's a sideline to sideline guy. As a matter of fact, Alexander is to this defense what Peterson is to the Oklahoma offense. He's a big-time player, but the Oklahoma's already missed three tackles on this drive.
And that's something that's plagued them in their first two games against Alabama-Birmingham and last week against Washington. Alvin Thibodeau, the defensive end at the bottom of the screen, in for the Sooners. And inside Stewart, touchdown Oregon. Another broken tackle from 2 yards out. Jonathan Stewart, CJ Ayu couldn't bring him down.
All the blocking goes this way, and he just comes up behind him and scores easily. Walks in.
Paul Martinez with the extra point. Hold to Brady Leaf, he's perfect. After near throwing a near interception on the first play of the game, they go four plays, 76 yards, in 1 minute, 21 seconds, and they lead the Oklahoma Sooners 7-0. Look out, Duck fans, this is number 28, Adrian Peterson back deep on this kickoff. First attempt this year for Peterson as Matt Evenson of the Ducks will tee it up. Peterson at the one. And he's corralled at about the 21. Good coverage by the Oregon special team. Oklahoma quarterback is 50-year senior Paul Thompson, making his fourth start at quarterback after playing some wide receiver last season. Perseverance should be his middle name. Joaquin Iglesias in motion. Thompson will throw on first down under pressure. He's got his man. That's fullback Ian Pleasant out of the backfield.
Well, because they're big. I mean, Kelly's 6'4", and Glacis is 6'2", and Joe John Finley's 6'6". So, I mean, these are big guys that really get out in the open. We just saw his little safety valve on a play action there, and they pick up the first down.
Peterson is deep in the I formation on first and 10, and he gets it. First carry. He doesn't get much. Cole Linehan and Jeremy Gibbs at the bottom of that pile for the Oregon defense. And it's that defensive line that's going to be really tested today, trying to keep down Adrian Peterson.
That defensive coordinator, Nick Aliotti, really challenged him as well. This is a defensive line that last year had a gap filler with Haloti Ngata, but he's gone. And so the guys down on that defensive line, they've given up a lot of yardage to the run. Aliotti says, now today is your challenge. Let me see if you can slow down Adrian Peterson. And that's quite a tall order.
Two tight ends for the Sooners. Will John Finley in motion. Here's Peterson right side. And he's hit immediately as he crosses the line of scrimmage. Blair Phillips, the middle linebacker, leading tackler for the Ducks, brings him down.
But I think the bottom line here is if they're going to put 8 and 9 guys in the box like they are, he's got to be able to break one-on-one tackles. He's got to be able to get to that second level.
Jarris Bird, you saw it, number 32 coming up. Casey did break that first tackle. Bird starting at corner for the first time. Willie Glasper is in now as Bird moves to the nickel back on this third down and 6. Time running down and time has run out on the play clock, but they let it go anyway. Throwing deep and incomplete. Cohen will punt for the Sooners. Back deep is Jeremiah Johnson. Johnson's brought back 6 punts this season for a healthy 15.5 yard average. Standing back at his 20-yard line. Almost blocked. Jameel Dowling almost blocked that. The ball is shanked out of bounds. From the 35 now, third and 15. Again, straight back over the middle. He's got it. Brian Paesinger with a big catch. Longest catch of his young career at Oregon. Dixon with time to throw found Paesinger for 35 yards.
Bodemir screen, slot receiver, Paesinger. He comes in. Ball is thrown right into the middle of the zone. Perfectly thrown. They came with a blitz, too. Playing some games up front. Almost got to Dixon. He stayed in there very, very comfortably and threw that pass perfectly.
And that was third and 15. Here's the option this time. Outside, it's Stewart. Diving down close to the 20-yard line. Dante Rosario with a clearing block on the perimeter. Nick Harris with the tackle, along with Jason Carter.
The Ducks have to feel very good about themselves right now. They're dominating the line of scrimmage. They've got the defense discombobulated a little bit. They're spreading them thin. They have to play one-on-one defense, and so far they haven't been able to do it.
Third and four now. Johnson, fake to him. Dixon's going to run. 20. 10 out of bounds. First down, Oregon. Pushed out of bounds by Reggie Smith. What a patient run for Dennis Dixon in traffic. 17 yards. Got away from C.J. Ayu.
Good play action. He looks downfield. He sees everybody covered. But more importantly, he sees a wide open middle of that field. And you mentioned the patience. Just sitting behind blockers, picking up blockers, picking his way as he goes.
He's fast, but he also has game speed. Runs as fast as he needs to.
Don't want to compare him to anybody, but he does remind you a little bit of Vince Young. You don't want to put him on that level, certainly, at this point in his career, but he does have those escapabilities.
Here's the option on first and goal. Bad pitch. Picked up by Stewart.
That's an
out of bounds.
Incomplete pass.
I was going to say that ball was pitched forward.
Therefore, it is incomplete.
I tell you what, this one may be challenged. It appears the design of this play was not to pitch this forward.
Well, so many of their plays are designed to be incomplete passes, but watch this one.
That may be a good call.
It's
it was
close.
So far out in front of Stewart. Here's a good look at it.
Even if they challenged it, I don't think there'd be indisputable video evidence to overturn that call.
Brady Leaf will hold for Paul Martinez from 21 yards out. Perfect. Scoring drive was highlighted by the third down and 15 pass to Paesinger from Dixon for 35 yards. And then Dixon with a fine run. This is Matt Evenson kicking off. And it's Adrian Peterson again. He's got a crease to the outside to the 30-yard line. Good return for Adrian Peterson. First and 10 for the Sooners now. Close to midfield. Peterson right up the middle, and he's got something. Broken tackle, first down. Adrian Peterson with his best run of the day. Broke the tackle of Patrick Chung.
Just exploded. Trap play, got good blocking, got into the second level.
14 yards of second level, Tim.
Boy, watch this. They block down this way. These guys come this way, and then he just comes and splits it right in the middle. Bam! Into the second level. Good tackle there to take him down, or he was gone.
Great block by Chris Messner, the senior left tackle. McEachern will hold. Hartley will try one from 41 yards away. Good snap and a good kick. This is Hartley to kick off. Deep from Oregon. Jeremiah Johnson, and he'll take it a couple yards deep. Across the 20-yard line. And down there, Stewart, left side, first down and more. Into the secondary, Jason Carter has to come in and lay it down. Didn't need a whole big, very big hole. He got through it and into the secondary quickly behind Shergi and Lucas up front.
Boy, and just you talk about space, you talk about thinning the box. Watch the running lane right here. And then, folks, see you later. There he goes. He gets into the second level, and it's a one-on-one play.
16 yards that time. Dixon in trouble. He's going to go down. Calvin Thibodeau. And the fans don't like the way they twisted the body of Dixon down to the ground. Latimer, number 46, the leading tackler for the Sooners. Like a broken play. Now that is how the first quarter will end. Back in Eugene, Oregon, along with Tim Brandt and Jack Root, I'm Dan Fouts, where the Ducks lead Oklahoma 10-3 to start the second quarter. It'll be second and 13 for Dixon. It's got and dropped. Brian Paysinger dropping that pass. Third and 13 for Dixon. He swings it out here to Stewart. He's got blockers in front, but he's not enough for a first down. Zach Latimer with another tackle with help from Nick Harris.
You know, Gary Crowton, the offensive coordinator for Oregon, scripts the first 25 plays. He has been so successful. This is a bestseller, this script. He should stay with it. He now has seen how they react. He'll make his little subtle adjustments, especially for down and distances. But right now, Oregon just rolling, and this is the first stop we've seen of Oklahoma today.
Decision time for Bellotti. He's going to check out his field goal kicker, Paul Martinez. Now he's going to go way deep too for this one, Tim.
Yeah, this is
yards
out of his range, I thought.
Leaf to hold, Stemmer to snap. And you're right, Tim. Comes up about 10, 15 yards shy. Flag down, Thompson. Throwing deep, he's got a man behind the secondary. Joaquin Iglesias walks into the end zone. Touchdown Sooners. 58-yard bomb. And it's coming back. Penalties continue to haunt Stoops' team. Iglesias moves. Fake to Peterson. Throw down the sidelines for Kelly. Thrown too far. Coverage by Walter Thurman, and Thurman cut off Kelly, couldn't get to that long throw. 0 for 5 now on third downs for the Sooners.
Well, the theory for the Sooners is good. Pass to get them out of the box so we can free up Peterson. But unless you hit these, and there's the contact, playing inside out, that is great defense. That's not interference. Great defense inside out using the sidelines. Unless he completes some of those passes, Dan, they're going to keep the box loaded.
No question about that, Tim. Cohen for another punt and another beauty. Really high. Fair catch ball by Johnson. Johnson! Ball bounced forward. It went under a Sooner, and now the Sooners have got it at the 20-yard line.
That's their biggest play of the game.
Jeremiah Johnson with his second fumble on a punt return this year. Recovery by Hayes. James Finley appears to have a bad shoulder as he goes to the sidelines. He was one of the first Ducks to try to recover this one.
Went right through his arms. Looked up, had it locked, called the fair catch. Didn't get his body under the ball, reached out. Watch this. Here's the fair catch, comes up. Never gets his body there, goes right through his arms, and that ball's loosened. The Sooners get it.
First and 10 at the Duck 20. Peterson right up the middle. And he runs right into A.J. Tuitelli. Tuitelli in the game for an injured Brent Haverly. You know, I love talking to Paul Thompson yesterday. I asked him his impressions of number 28. First word, dependability.
He's solid and never gives the tackler his full body.
And his second thought was he's going to make at least one huge play a game. Third and goal from the 13. Thompson to throw for it. He's got Finley. No, Brody Eldridge. And Eldridge is knocked out of bounds, short of the goal line. Leading tackler for the Ducks coming into today, Patrick Chung, gets Eldridge out of bounds here.
All right, Eldridge turns it up now and lowers that shoulder. Still really nice play just to get him out of bounds.
Going to mark this one just inside the 11. So this will be a 20-yard field goal attempt. And he's got it. 2:01 to go in the first half. We realize we're having some video problems. We apologize for those. We're working on it. Don't want you to miss any of this one. This one's got the feeling of a last-second play to win this one. Here's Hartley to kick off. And deep for Oregon. This is a good kickoff. Jeremiah Johnson. Barely out to the 20-yard line. Stewart's got it. Big hole. Midfield. Sooner territory. Jason Carter with the tackle. Jonathan Stewart having a monster first half against the Sooners.
Well, he says he's got a lot to prove. Here he is. And then you just watch him just kind of explode, but he gets great blocking up front. Sees the hole, dances through it. Now he's in the second level, explodes. And keep in mind, he's 234 pounds. So not only is he fast, but he's also very powerful. He's shorter than Peterson, but wears the same number and possesses a lot of the same talents.
Third and three for Oregon. 20 seconds in the half. Swing to Stewart. He's got the first down. Oh, and he almost had more. So Oregon will be forced to use their last timeout. But again, the Ducks convert on third down.
They go IU. CJ IU's out of the ballgame. He's hurt. That's your defensive end.
Clock running. This will be the last play of the first half. A home run ball to the end zone, incomplete. Marcus Walker with another fine play on Jason Williams. And they've got 2 seconds left.
You can't defend any better than this. We talked Walker should have gotten a flag on the last one. Here he plays him inside out, uses the sideline for leverage, and plays this ball perfectly. Look how he separates the receiver from the ball by getting in between him with his body. Nicely done.
Ball underthrown by Dixon, not taking advantage of the 6'4", Jason Williams. So Martinez will come on from 48 yards out. He missed badly from 51. This one online. And good! Hit the crossbar and went through.
Martinez is even shaking his head on that one. Are you kidding me?
Jack, you've got Bob Stoops with you.
Yes, I do. Coach, how do you change threes into touchdowns?
Well, penalties. We got the ball second down and two at the two. We've had a touchdown called back because of a penalty. We had to have some discipline, not hurt ourselves with some simple penalties. That's the biggest factor, and then two big plays on defense. So we're actually, with all that that's happened, we're sitting here in a good game.
Good luck, Coach.
Thank you, Jack. Paul Martinez, who was the Pac-10 Special Teams Player of the Week last week for his touchdown run against Fresno State, gets lucky on this one.
Led the nation in field goals made. This counts. There's no pictures and no statistics. Bam, hit the crossbar, and it went the correct way. Good.
It went the correct way if you're wearing green and yellow. Welcome back to Autzen Stadium. Dan Fouts along with Tim Brandt, where the Oregon Ducks are up 13-6. And Tim, one of the questions for the Ducks coming into this game was how would they hold up at the cornerback position?
Well, Nick Aliotti told us that, but I think he knew these two corners can play. Redshirt freshman, they had to step up today. There's no question but the fact they did. How about Thurman with the big sack here? They came on the corner blitz. That's how much confidence they had. They look at Thurman with the coverage here. They bracket Kelly. They get him inside out. And then how about this? Here comes Bird, make the tackle, knock him out of bounds. They were loading the box. They were putting 6, 7, 8 guys in the box to stop Peterson. And then the corners are doing what Nick Aliotti knew they could do.
Take a look at our starting running backs comparison. Adrian Peterson and Jonathan Stewart. 7.1 yard average for Stewart is below his season average of 7.4. He also has caught 3 passes for another 19 yards.
Dan, let's summarize that first half just by saying Oklahoma 6 penalties, 0 for 6 on third downs, no touchdowns. Patterson just 50 yards.
That's summarizing. Evenson with a low kickoff gets away and into the end zone where Adrian Peterson will down it. 47-yard line of Oregon. Peterson right side. He's got some room. Oh, fine tackle by Jarris Bird, or Peterson was gone down the sideline.
Dan, this is what they were talking about. This is what ED was talking about. Eric Dickerson on the left, Adrian Peterson on the right. Stand-up runners, both big. They've got that great vision, great explosive speed, and very, very strong. Very similar in the styles when you watch them side by side.
No question about that, and we almost saw that live action of Peterson on that play. Here he is on second and two. Tuatelli dives in there and takes his legs out. Remember, Tuatelli is taking over for Brent Haberle, who injured his right elbow, and he's done for the day. So this is depth of Oregon on defense.
And one of the biggest differences in the ball game so far has been the tackling of Oregon and the missed tackles by Oklahoma's defense. So if you look at the two defenses in this ball game, Oregon doing a spectacular job of one-on-one tackling, wrapping arms, making sure the ball carrier goes down.
Play clock running down, and they're still in the huddle. Remember, they used all three of their timeouts in the first quarter. They're going to use their first timeout of the second half here at the start of the third quarter.
Bob Stoops had to call it, and he's furious.
Thompson to throw for it. He's in trouble. Now he's got a man wide open. Iglesias inside the five. Iglesias down to the 1 yard line. What a throw by Paul Thompson.
Man, what made that throw even more incredible was the pressure that Oregon got on him. Chung shaken up a little bit, came on the safety blitz. But watch this. Here's the bottom of your screen. Iglesias takes the middle. And just the throw was perfect from a guy who was under a lot of pressure and was actually hit as he released the ball. Terrific play. Third and one. Everybody thinks, okay, it's going to Peterson. But watch this. Chung on the backside. He's on his way down when he releases the ball and when he finds Iglesias. Big time play.
37-yard gain down to the 1 yard line on third and one. All arm by Paul Thompson.
Give it to Peterson now.
He's in the I formation. Thompson takes it forward on the sneak. No signal. Blair Phillips, A.J. Tuatelli trying to hold him out.
You know,
Yesterday
we talked at great length with Adrian Peterson. Just know the kind of guy he is. Look, he's looking over the sidelines now saying, give it to me. Give it to me. He's frustrated. He's a competitor. He wants the ball. Doesn't care how many guys are in the box or how they're stopping him. He wants the football.
Thompson is 6'4", 214. Looks like his helmet got over, but where's the ball? Tough to tell. Peterson, again a sneak. And this time, he's in. Touchdown, Oklahoma.
I don't know. I think taking it back to Peterson at any time is good.
Oh, I agree. I'm saying there's that theory, and they certainly went to the quarterback sneak. I'm with you. I was calling for Peterson both plays.
Here's Garrett Hartley to tie the ball game. He does. Jeremiah Johnson and Andy L. Brown will be deep for Mike Bellotti's Ducks. And he kicks this one. It may go out of bounds. And it does. Dixon fires to the outside, and Jason Williams has got it, and he's close to a first down.
Jason Williams.
Nick Harris on the tackle, but Stewart, or rather Williams, just lowered his head and drove forward close to that first down.
And Dixon threw that thing on a rope. I mean, he's got his confidence back. He's stepping into the throw. Here's the route. Williams slides to the outside, and the ball's perfectly thrown right around the face mask.
Lindy Holmes playing awfully soft there. Stewart up the middle, first down, Oregon. Jason Carter got him by an ankle.
Or he was gone. Carter doesn't make that tackle. There was nothing but daylight in front of him. This looks like the first Oregon drive.
Well, you notice the tempo. They're back to the no huddle, getting right to the line of scrimmage and calling the play. Here's Stewart again, right up the middle. He's got a couple inside the 30. Ball's loose, and the Sooners have got it. Darian Williams with the recovery of the Jonathan Stewart fumble. Rufus Alexander with the big hit.
Second fumble of the game for Oregon, and another huge break for the Sooners. That rubber band was stretching. Defense was given chunks.
Now, you know, sooner or later, that Rufus Alexander is going to make a play. He is to the Sooner defense what Adrian Peterson is to the Sooner offense. First and 10 for the Sooners. Iglesias in motion again. Fake to Peterson. throw to Iglesias, and he's got it. 35-yard line. Another fine throw on the run by Paul Thompson. And just the physical part is big for Thompson, Jack, but that leadership is so much more important.
Well, and we saw it when we came back from our last break when Paul Thompson was talking to all of his offensive linemen. But as upset or maybe as hyper as Adrian Peterson has been for all the first 30 minutes of this game, now into about 40 minutes of this game, Paul Thompson has been just the opposite. He's been very calm, very cool, very collected on the field, and especially when he's been off the field. Kind of makes sense to me when you realize he's been around for so long, Dan, that they call him Pops.
And he doesn't like it either, does he? He likes PT. First and 10 for PT and the Sooners. Jeremy Gibbs went out with an injury. Fahatete in for Oregon. Here's Peterson, right side. Not much there, but look at that leg drive. Kwame Ajiman goes for a ride.
Nick Aliotti's got to be frustrated, the defensive coordinator for Oregon. His game plan was working to perfection, and they still have held Peterson to only 66 yards on the afternoon. He says Thompson's got to beat us. Well, now Thompson's starting to connect on these passes.
They've been hard yards for Peterson, too. Second and 6. Finley shifts. Thompson to throw. Pump fake. Throwing to Kelly deep. He's got it. Touchdown, Oklahoma. Beating Walter Thurman. Malcolm Kelly with a touchdown grab.
All right, here comes Kelly. Sit down, draw up Thurman, the freshman. Now try to run into the corner. A little push off by Kelly. Readjusts on the football because Thurman lost sight of it. And the touchdown.
So Kelly gets his touchdown reception. 31 yards. Oklahoma has their first lead of the afternoon. And Hartley adds to it. Back at Autzen Stadium, where number 15, Oklahoma, by 7. Johnson looking for room to run. Now he's in big trouble. Jeremiah Johnson going backwards and down inside the 15-yard line. Well, he is from Texas, Longview, Texas, Jack. Dixon on first and 10. Throws over the middle to Rosario. And what a catch in traffic. One more time by the big tight end, Dante Rosario. Between Darian Williams and Rufus Alexander.
Big, strong, tough body, soft hands.
14 yards on first and 10 for the Ducks.
And he, too, can get separation. Look at him sit down in the open area, the soft spot, make the catch. They just have to protect the football. Oklahoma's converted both Oregon fumbles to 10 points.
Stewart breaking tackles. First down, Oregon. Jason Carter couldn't bring him down. You know, the one thing Oregon hasn't gotten anything today is out of their quarterback, except on an ad-lib type of run. Dixon has not carried the ball in the option at all today.
People forget about Jonathan Stewart coming into this ball game. Everybody was talking about Adrian Peterson. Stewart in high school ran for over 2,300 yards. He's got great speed, 32 touchdowns. That was just his senior year.
It's got Rosario one more time, and Rosario delivers the blow on Reggie Smith going out of bounds. And they're going to talk about it for a little bit.
Well, and this is what we talked about earlier, Dan. One of the things about this stretch offense last year, Oregon didn't use the tight end. They never, ever got him in there. He wasn't a point of emphasis, and they couldn't maximize it. Now they do with Rosario. That's 5 catches for 41 yards for Rosario.
Second and short. Stewart right side. First down, Oregon. Sooner territory down to the 45-yard line. Determined running by Jonathan Stewart, Latimer, and Harris on the stop.
And Oregon just took this up a notch. This drive, they're getting more physical, and Jonathan Stewart is leading the way. Incredibly productive running back, blocker, receiver. What a talent.
110 yards for Jonathan Stewart on 17 carries. First and 10 from the 45. Receiver screen to Finley. And he's got a few. He's close to another first down. Oregon looking to respond to Oklahoma's touchdown. Stewart in the backfield with Dixon. Fake to Stewart. Outside to Jason Williams. Oh, and a good tackle. Lendy Holmes comes up and stops him dead in his tracks. The former wide receiver with a good play.
He read it from the get-go, too. He saw the step off and then the step back from the little slip screen outside. He broke him the ball quickly. Watch the top of your screen. All right, he reads the play. Look at him. And he's a full sprint now to make the tackle. Breaks down, hits him around the waist, wraps his arm, and drives him back.
And Ayu did a good job of coming out in pursuit, keeping Williams from turning it inside. Good double-team tackle there for the Sooners. Third and two now. Stewart, strength, power, first down Oregon. Zach Latimer is taken for a ride. ESPN presentation of college football on ABC will return after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Third down now and six. They've converted 7 of 12 today on third downs. Dixon throws, incomplete. Jason Carter knocked it away from Brian Pasinger. Jack, this injury list continues to grow for both teams.
Yeah, Dan, I'm starting to think like I'm at Gray's Anatomy rather here than here in Autzen Stadium. Let's start with DeMarcus Granger, defensive tackle for Oklahoma. He tweaked his back. They've stretched it. He's been cleared to return to play. Not the same for Jeremy Gibbs on the Ducks' defensive line. He has injured his right ankle and is being iced. And James Finley, their wide receiver for the Ducks, the left ankle is the problem there, and he's still being taped. It's awfully tender.
Well, this is a tender moment, too. Fourth and six for the Ducks from the Sooner 30. Dixon to throw deep. He's got a man deep. Jason Williams, touchdown, Oregon. Fourth and six. They go for six and get it to number four. This is Martinez with the extra point. Leaf puts it down. Martinez puts it through.
Dan, the touchdown was set up, though, by the offensive line, giving Dixon plenty of time to sit back, read, and find Williams.
30 yards on fourth down and six. You are watching ESPN College Football on ABC. At Autzen Stadium. It may be separation Saturday, but two teams this afternoon. Fourth quarter and Oregon strikes on the 30-yard touchdown pass from Dixon to Jason Williams. This is Matt Evenson to kick off. Short kickoff. Peterson's got it. 20. Glasper's got him. And he gets out to close to the 30-yard line. Jack, what do you got?
Well, Dan, remember Jason Williams, as you alluded to last week, had a case of the drops. He's dropping a lot of balls. In fact, even early in this game, dropped a couple of them. Well, you would think that maybe his team might have turned on him. That was not the case. We asked Gary Crowton about it, and he said the team has been very, very supportive. But if you remember, guys, he also pointed out that the only one that can build that confidence back is Jason Williams. He worked all week on catching the ball, and with that TD catch, I believe the confidence is back.
30-yard line is where the Sooners will start. Peterson stumbling forward. Cole Linehan first to meet him.
What a job by this defense on Peterson all day. Best running back in college football. He's got 19 carries for 66 yards. They've kept him bottled up all day, never away from the line of scrimmage. They contain him on the outside, force him in the inside, then get 3 and 4 green jerseys on top of it.
And yet, you still have the feeling that any time he can go the distance. Gets stronger as the game goes on. Give him a yard on that last play. Finley in motion on second and nine. fake to Peterson. Thompson in trouble. Another fine throw on the run. Joaquin Iglesias in front of Thurman. Personal foul penalty came in after this play. So this
after the play was over, dead ball. Personal foul on the defense. 15 yards via the run. Automatic first down.
Wow.
It's like Matt Tuena may have been the guilty party as Mike Bellotti addresses the situation. Big penalty. That will move the ball all the way into duck territory. But what a throw by Thompson.
Throw by Thompson. Pick up the first tag. 15 more on top of it. They're picking up yardage in chunks and now in duck territory.
7 of 9 here in the second half with a touchdown pass.
Find out if they can break Peterson.
Tie ball game, 20-20. Eldridge in motion. Peterson left side. And J.D. Nelson wraps him up, but not before he has one of his better runs of the afternoon.
Well, you had the feeling they were going to try to break Peterson as they moved into Oregon territory, and they finally got the cutoff blocks they needed. Watch this now. He's going to his left side, and look at the offensive line. They slide down, they engage, they get the block, they hold him up just long enough, get him into the secondary. Weak block by Kelly, but he still picks up 5-7 yards after that, and he's a big guy for yaks. You know, yards after contact. Watch this. He's hit here. 1, 2, 3. Still picks up another 5 yards after the initial contact.
16 yards total. Fake to Peterson this time. Incomplete. Thompson throwing short for Malcolm Kelly. 3rd and 11 for Paul Thompson. Gives to Peterson left side. And he's close to a first down. Knocked out of bounds there by Walter Thurman. I would be surprised if Stoops goes for it on fourth down if Peterson was short with that dive.
Thurman comes up talking to Peterson too.
Probably saying, ouch.
Watch the end of this. Great explosion to get around the corner, then ducks that head and goes right after Thurman.
Peterson goes about 220. Thurman goes about 170.
See, the ouch. Defensive guy's got to get his angles over. He's got to punish the ball carrier no matter what his size is. Peterson is some kind of special, isn't he?
Yeah, and I think they got a special mark by the officials.
Easy now, big guy.
It's close. Inches.
Just short.
Well, earlier in the game, Thompson took a quarterback sneak in from inches away.
Two in a row. Ran the sneak twice.
Let's go, baby! Let's go! Let's go!
I like this call by Stoops, though. You've got momentum. Your offense is working very well here in the second half.
And you're on the road. Try to take the crowd out of it. Get the first.
And you've got Adrian Peterson in your backfield. Three tight ends for the Sooners. Finley, Eldridge, and Pleasant. Pleasant will line up as the fullback in front of Adrian Peterson. Peterson's got it. He's got a first down and more. High step and touchdown, Adrian Peterson. Great block by George Robinson, the Duke. And Stoops is rewarded by a touchdown from Adrian Peterson.
Oregon jammed that defensive line really tight, waiting for the sneak or Peterson to get that half yard. And they didn't have anybody in the secondary level. Look at this running room right here. I mean, there's nobody back there. Everybody jammed up front to stop the short yardage play. No safety valves.
So Hartley will try to increase the lead to 7. And he does. Oklahoma's last 2 touchdowns came on 4th down plays. The bomb to Malcolm Kelly. Then the gut shot by Adrian Peterson, 17 yards, touchdown. Hartley will kick off. Chris Vincent and number 27, Andiel Brown, deep for Oregon. This is Vincent to the 20, 25-yard line, then out of bounds.
Game has gone back and forth. Oregon scored first to get this game going. Crowd was going crazy. Sellout crowd, fire marshal crowd. Then in the second half, this is Thompson on third down and long. A lot of pressure coming on the blitz. He threw a strike, got it down to the one. Thompson with the quarterback sneak gave him the lead. This is what we're talking about now in the third quarter. This touchdown pass to Kelly. They outscored him 14-0 in the third. Dixon came right back. Threw a strike, and then Peterson on short yardage, fourth and inches, explodes. Nobody in the secondary. Peterson now with 109 yards for the game.
Dixon on first down, rolls, almost intercepted. It is intercepted. Nick Harris gets the deflection, and the Sooners are back in business. First interception thrown by Dennis Dixon all year long, and what a horrible time for it to happen for Duck fans.
And look out, folks, the floodgates could be opening here. Oregon dominated the first half of play, but Oklahoma now wearing them out, and turnovers have made the difference. Dixon again with plenty of time. Throws right into coverage, and Latimer tipped the football before it was intercepted. Great play by the linebacker, Zach Latimer.
He's in the I formation, Finley in motion. Peterson's got it right side, huge hole inside the 10, inside the 5. First down, Oklahoma. Adrian Peterson behind the big block by Ian Pleasant, his fullback.
You don't have to be a Phi Beta Kappa to know that Peterson is the guy that needs the football in his hands to make things happen. Cooper, the center, now is down on the field. A couple of Oregon Ducks are down on the field. Fatigue becoming a factor in a very, very physical football game.
Right, you can see just how far down the field middle linebacker Blair Phillips is before he gets to Adrian Peterson. Peterson deep in the I formation. Third and goal. Peterson up the middle. Nothing there.
Stoned him.
Blair Phillips among the tacklers. J.D. Nelson as well. I'm surprised with a freshman center in the game that the Sooners would attack right up the middle.
Boy, watch Blair Phillips, though. Gets into the hole, meets him right here, tuck the tail, sky the eyes, now driving backwards. Help is on its way. Great play by 33, Blair Phillips, the leading tackler on this defense.
So Hartley will come on to increase this Sooner lead to 10. Ball will be placed at the 20-yard line by Hayes McEachern. Derek Shaw with the snap. Good snap, good hold, good kick. So Oklahoma increases their lead to 10 with 6:45 to go in the fourth quarter. Oklahoma starting to separate from Oregon with a 10-point lead. Hartley to kick off.
Yeah.
And it's a good kick. Oh, all the way back into the end zone. NDL Brown will touch a knee down, and the ball will come out to the 20-yard line. Rosario and Kent to the bottom of the screen now. Williams to the top. Paysinger in the slot. Dixon over the middle. Intercepted. Intercepted by Nick Harris, his second of the game. Trying to go one more time inside to Jason Williams, but Harris is all over it. Two interceptions for Harris here in the fourth quarter.
And Dixon came into this ballgame. He hadn't been sacked all year. He hadn't thrown a pick all year. And here's his second. Again, he got pretty good protection. Just throws into coverage. And not well thrown. Williams never had a chance to make the catch. White jerseys are everywhere. Harris, the nickelback, just sat there and waited.
Good call by Brent Venables. Going to the zone there. Trying to eat up time. Got the interception. Here's Peterson, left side, 40, out of bounds, near midfield, close to a first down. Thank you, John. Trojans are tough.
You know, right now, Mike Bellotti's got to be shell-shocked. His team dominated the first half, and pretty much had their way in the third quarter early until Oklahoma took over a couple turnovers. They turned them into points, steamrolled that into 14 third quarter points. Now they're in control of the game.
First and 10 for Peterson, right side, and he's rolling now. Another 9-10-yard gain for Adrian Peterson on first down. Brandon Braxton, the sophomore from Youngstown, with a big block. Jack, Adrian Peterson is responding, wouldn't you say?
Yes, indeed, and he had to respond after the first game against UAB when Kevin Wilson, the offensive coordinator, scolded him despite the fact that he rushed for 139 yards and a TD. He said, you didn't pick up your pass protection right. You didn't run with the reckless abandon, and you tried to be too fancy. You know what Adrian Peterson did? He apologized to the team.
No apology necessary today as he breaks the tackle down the sideline, inside the 5-yard line, where he's horse-collared and thrown out of bounds. Patrick Chung, among others.
And he's slow to get up, but what a talent.
At some point, he's got to get tired, doesn't he?
That might be a door slammer. You know, with the ready-to-play rule to speed up the game this year, you might lose 18 seconds or so on every possession. So when you look at what Oregon has with 4:20 left in the ballgame, they're running short when they need two scores now, and it looks like it's going to be three. Right here, it's like he gives himself up to the tackler, and then he comes up and gets him around the head, and again, he falls funny. See how he just kind of gave himself up? And when his body went limp, that's when he took the hit and went down hard on that right side.
And Peterson's got it on third and goal. Left side and out of bounds, and that'll stop the clock, and that's a real big benefit to Oregon. A.J. Tuatelli with another tackle and stopping the clock as Garrett Hartley comes out to try to add to this 10-point lead for Oklahoma.
Well, good pursuit again by the Oregon defense. They got blocks all the way to the side, and Peterson waited for his blocking, but by waiting for his blocking, he allowed the pursuit to catch him and take him out of bounds. So he tried to stay in. He just couldn't fight against the defense.
22-yard attempt here from a severe angle. McEachern puts it down, and Hartley puts it through. Garrett Hartley with his third. Make that his fourth field goal of the afternoon.
Which tells the Ducks that they now need two touchdowns, and they've got to do it in 3 minutes and 12 seconds. So we'll see how Mike Bellotti now manages the clock.
Hartley will squib this one down the field, and it'll go out of bounds. That's another break for Oregon. Daniel Brown let it go out of bounds. Ball will be placed on the 35-yard line. Dixon on first and 10. Fakes to Stewart. Pressure. Now he's going to run. He'll get about six, but he needs a whole lot more than that. Ducks have two timeouts. Clock continues to roll as the receivers slowly get back to the line of scrimmage. Jason Williams heading for the sidelines, and he gets out of bounds. Marcus Walker pushes him out. First down, Oregon. But Oklahoma will give that type of play to the Ducks every day.
That's exactly right, because right now, if you look at the defense and they're being instructed from the sidelines, keep everybody in front of you. As long as they keep them in front, they don't care if the clock stops momentarily, because once they set it, boom, it's going again. Just keep everybody in front of you.
First and 10 from midfield. Stewart up the middle, and he's tripped up by his own lineman. Anoka Lucas was pushed back. That tripped up Jonathan Stewart.
This will probably take it under 2 minutes. They've got to hurry up. They've got to get it going.
Gain of two. Dixon to the outside. Williams has got it. And he smartly steps out of bounds at the 30-yard line in front of Reggie Smith. Stops that clock. Dixon's got Rosario over the middle down to the 25-yard line. Clock continues to roll. Gain of 6 on that one.
But they're being fairly efficient with the clock. 1:46 left. They're still moving the ball. They're almost down to the red zone. Get a score. Think about the onside kick. Then measure the clock again.
AD, I know this man.
All day.
Toby Keith on the sideline. Big Sooner fan. Happy he made the trip to Eugene.
Well, see that all day. That refers to Adrian Peterson, a nickname AD. 34 carries, 211 yards, and the touchdown. Spectacular afternoon. And I'm with you 100% on Jason Williams. What an afternoon he had. 8 catches, 158 yards, and a touchdown for the Ducks.
Ducks need a score in a big hurry.
I know nobody's leaving this stadium.
Ball on the 25-yard line. Bad snap through his legs. Dixon goes down. And you talk about a killer play at the worst possible time. A low snap from Anoka Lucas goes between the quarterback's legs, and they lose a bunch of yards.
And losing time. The clock continues to roll. The receivers were down by the end zone. Now have to get all the way back.
Dixon steps up. Now he throws. He's got Williams again on the sidelines. And again, he gets out of bounds, 16-yard line. Now you got to start putting the ball in the end zone and letting these tall receivers of Oregon, especially Williams, go up and try for one.
Yeah, and this is where Mike Bellotti now is cursing that new rule under his breath. Boy, the new clock rule really shortens the game when you're in your hurry-up offense down the stretch.
First and 10 from the 16. Dixon steps up. He's going to run. Five.
He's got it.
10. Touchdown, Oregon! Dennis Dixon from 16 yards out.
What a football game. And a great read by Dixon.
He just ran away from people, too. First time the second half he's gotten loose on the ground. Martinez with the extra point. Perfect. .109 to go in the fourth quarter from Autzen Stadium in Eugene. Don't go anywhere. This one's not over yet. You're watching ESPN College Football on ABC. 109 to go in the fourth quarter. Oklahoma on top by 6. Both teams have one timeout. You've got to anticipate the onside kick here for Oregon.
And they know if they don't get it, Dan, it's over. They've got to get the onside kick.
And it's the coach's kid who's going to kick it. Luke Bellotti, the junior from Sheldon High School here in Eugene. He'll attempt this onside kick. And Oklahoma calls their last timeout.
And the reason they call that timeout, they wanted to see the alignment of the onside kick team. They wanted to see how they would line up and which onside kick they were going to try to perform. Bob Stoops telling his sure hands team that all they have to do is recover this thing, make the catch,
and
the game's over.
Yes, it is.
And a smart thing to do is even step up. That ball's got to go 10 yards before the defense, before the kicking team can get to it and recover it legally. So attack the football if you're the sure hands team.
Yeah, and the benefit that Bellotti has is artificial surface. The ball just seems to, if you hit it right, get the right bounce, it'll go way up high in the air and give the kicking team a real good shot at it. You can see all the athletes for Oklahoma on the field. Wide receivers, running backs, defensive backs.
A lot of adjustments being made by the Sooners.
Here's Luke Bellotti. Buggy wants to kick it to the left side now, and Oregon shifts over there.
Do you believe it?
And then the wrestling match at the bottom, and Oregon comes out with it.
Oklahoma.
Patrick Chung may have been at the bottom there.
But hold on, Oklahoma's got the football. And they're saying, wait a minute, the pileup's over there. We've got the ball over here.
But if this goes to review, it's going to be awful difficult to reverse this call. Question is, does the ball go 10 yards before it's touched by the receiving team?
It's actually hit before 10 yards, and it's hit by an Oregon player. That's illegal.
Ball was taken away. First down.
Boy, I don't know. That ball was touched before it went 10 yards. But it's going to be first down Ducks. Well, shouldn't be.
Stoops can challenge this. He has a timeout. Well, he used his timeout on the kickoff when they made the adjustments on the onside kick, so he cannot challenge us, but it is reviewable, as every play is in college football.
No question in my mind, it was touched first by an Oregon Duck, and it didn't go 10 yards before he touched it. Now they're going to go over and look at this play and review it. Take a look at this thing. You tell me if it goes 10 yards, and you tell me who hit it first.
That's the question, who hit it first? Great kick by the coach's son, Luke Bellotti. Oregon touched
it
first.
No question. That was Oregon. And it didn't go 10 yards.
May have been Brian Paysinger, number 19. That's awful close from that angle.
Keep in mind, it's got to be indisputable video evidence. This is a good angle right here. Go up for it.
Malcolm Kelly way up in the air, number 4 for Oklahoma. Chung did get the recovery.
Should be Oklahoma football, but instead, Oregon's offense is on the field. And here comes the call.
After review, there's conclusive video evidence that the ball was touched by a receiving team player, which makes the ball live. Oregon ball, first down.
That's a bad call. That's a bad call. The ball was touched first by an Oregon player, not the receiving team, not Malcolm Kelly. So the Ducks get an incredible break. They'll have the ball at the 48-yard line, 106 to go, one timeout to work with. Horrible call by the review referee. Dixon over the middle to Stewart. 45-yard line, heading for the sidelines, 40 out of bounds. Jonathan Stewart with the speed to take it from the middle of the field all the way to the sideline.
The call is a moot point now. 54 seconds left for the Ducks. There's plenty of time. No panic is necessary. They've got time using the sidelines and timeouts. No timeouts are left for Oklahoma. One is left for Oregon. So Oregon in the catbird seat there. They just have to manage this clock.
37-yard line for Dixon. Over the middle. He's got incomplete. Flag down. Flag comes in. Darian Williams may get called for pass interference on Brian Paysinger. Oklahoma came with a blitz. Oklahoma had to play man-to-man in the secondary, and the free safety Williams is going to get called. Boy, the Oregon Ducks were dead ducks until that call. Sooners led 33-20 with 3 minutes and 12 seconds remaining in the
pass
game.
Interference defense, number 41.
Automatic first down.
First down.
Dan, now they really don't have to rush.
They got to rush a little bit. They do have 50 seconds. And you know what, Tim? You're right, because they do have one timeout.
No, that's exactly right. They've got the sidelines. They've got one timeout. They do not have to rush. As a matter of fact, they want to melt the clock. Touchdown and an extra point gives them the game.
If you're Oklahoma, I would keep my eye on number 4, Jason Williams. He's had a huge game for Oregon.
9 catches, 177 yards and a touchdown, I'd say.
Last play will be reviewed.
Again, it's got to be indisputable video evidence, but we've got a pretty good shot of it. Watch the bottom of your screen. Right here, 99. Looks like he changed the flight of the ball, because then it becomes a wobbling dead duck, so to speak.
Easy. No, you're right. C.J. Ayu with a heck of a play. That ball, Dennis Dixon always throws spirals. That ball was not a spiral. when it got to the receiver.
But again, Dan, indisputable video evidence, and I'm not sure it's there. I mean, I saw it on the onside kick. I don't see it there. Adrian Peterson, 34 carries, 211 yards. Phenomenal afternoon.
After review, there is no conclusive video evidence that the ball was tipped. Therefore, the play stands.
I tell you what.
Except that it changed directions.
Well, it got out of spiral. And having thrown a lot of balls, it got out of spiral. I don't like that excuse that somebody tipped it.
Oh, you're too much.
I tell you what. First and 10 now for Oregon. They're in striking distance.
And still have a timeout.
That means they can throw the ball over the middle of the field. Fake to Stewart. To the end zone! Touchdown, Oregon! Brian Paysinger from Dennis Dixon!
The whole stadium is rocking.
First career touchdown for Brian Paysinger, the junior from Long Beach, California, Wilson High School. And this is the extra point by Martinez. Got it!
But there's still 46 seconds for the Sooners. Did they score too quickly? This play is set up, Dan, by the offensive line. They did a great job of giving him protection. Then look at the bottom. Number 19, Paysinger, does a little step dance, goes by Harris. And number 5, Harris, who has 2 interceptions. If you're even, he's leaving. Just gave him the stutter step. He bit on it. Harris, just a sophomore. Boy, what a nice throw, too. He waited for the fake, the stop and go. Saw him clear. Once he got the separation, laid the ball in perfectly to Paysinger.
And remember, it was Paysinger who illegally touched the onside kick, at least in our eyes. Ball was given to Oregon with the recovery by Patrick Chung. Quick strike offense. 2 touchdowns in 22 seconds.
But hold on, there's still 46 seconds left, and look who's back to return his kick.
The Sooners have no timeouts.
Adrian Peterson.
Now, do you squib it or do you kick it deep?
I wouldn't kick it deep and give Peterson a chance to return it.
The other guy's a pretty good returner, too. Reggie Smith is back along with Peterson.
Just kick it to one of the up men. There it is.
This is Reggie Smith. He's got a big hole. 40. Reggie Smith ducked. Territory down the sidelines. Knocked out of bounds.
Clock stops with 31 seconds left.
But once the referee signals ready to play, the clock will roll. Garrett Hartley's career long is 52 yards. Kicked that one last year against Texas, but he's in field goal range now.
Tried to keep it away from the receivers. They wanted the up men here to take it, but they left it on the ground. This is a great return. Look at the patience waiting for blocks to set. Cuts back inside. Peterson gets a block. All the way down deep. Now the offense will come up. No huddle. Clock's rolling again. Down to 25.
54 yards on the return by Reggie Smith. Finley in motion. Peterson gets it right side. He's tackled at the line of scrimmage.
No timeouts left. Down to 12.
Thompson has got to kill the clock with a spike here. And he does, with 2 seconds gone.
Peterson's a great player, but I can't understand the run call when you don't have any timeouts left.
Well, apparently Stoops wanted the ball in the right hash mark for Garrett Hartley.
Hartley's longest this year is 44 yards. His career long is 52.
Well, this will do it on Separation Saturday. One of these teams is going to be very happy in 2 seconds. Derek Shaw to snap. Hayes McEachern to hold. Garrett Hartley from 44. Timeout, Oregon.
Last timeout. Again, I understand what he's doing to line up the angle. But I'd still, with 25 seconds left, take a shot, get to the sidelines, and get him down where the field goal is more a chip shot.
4 for 4 on the day. Stoops has confidence that this is in Hartley's range.
He has not missed this season. This will be from 44 yards out. And again, we tell you, his longest this year was 44. His longest for his career, 52. This crowd is deafening.
44 yards away for Garrett Hartley. For the win. Blocked! Blocked by Oregon! Oregon has beaten Oklahoma for the first time in 7 tries on a blocked field goal.
Dan, when you're at the limits of your distance. You get into it, the kick's a little bit lower. They put the center rush on, they came up big for the block.
Jack!
Coach!
Yeah.
Describe to me the last 30 seconds of this game.
I'm not sure I really can, Jack. Our kids just wouldn't say die. Our defense did a great job. Our offense turned the ball over way too much, but they came through big time when we needed it. Our defense and those special teams with that block, that's a lot of fun. It'll be a lot of fun in the game tonight.
What did you tell the special teams on that last kick?
On the kickoff? Well, it was a squib middle, which was designed to screw up their timing. We did a very poor job of coverage, gave them a chance. It shouldn't have come down to that, but, now I'll take it. It's okay.
7th time's the charm.
Yeah, that's what I said. So I use that in my pregame speech, you know that?
Come on, baby! Guys!
Thanks, Jack. Bellotti now is 25-1 here at Autzen Stadium against non-conference teams. Sooners led it 33-20 with 3:12 to go. 3 minutes and 10 seconds later, Garrett Hartley's field goal try is stuffed in the middle of the defensive line by middle linebacker Blair Phillips.
The longer the kick, the lower the line, and allowed them to get up and block that kick.
Once again, our final score, Oregon 34, Oklahoma 33. For Tim Brandt and Jack Garut, I'm Dan Fouts. Good night, everybody.